and welcome to the Googleplex. This is an incredible place with lots of great stuff being worked on every single day. Before I worked here, I always wondered what it would be like to come to the Googleplex, meet up with a Googler, and have coffee with them, and just chat about what they do, how they do it, and why they do it. And today we're going to do exactly that. So welcome to this episode of Coffee with a Googler. And one of the things that we've been doing since we started the show is we've been asking about which Googlers you'd like to speak with, which Googlers you'd like me to have a conversation with, and what kind of topics we could talk about. And the first name that came up was Colt McCanlis. He's also the name that came up the most often. So Colt, you're finally with us. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. So I just want to make sure that this is clear. I want to make sure I understand this.
Yep.
I outranked Larry Page. To be here.
Your page rank is higher than Larry Page's rank.
Thank you, community, for voting me here. I mean, like, what does Larry have to talk about?
I don't know. I will talk about him with him someday, and we'll see what he has to say. And I'd love to hear what he has to say about you.
Well, you shouldn't probably ask him about me.
I'll give it a try. So, Colt, you're a developer advocate here at Google, and tell us what is a developer advocate and what do they do?
Well, it's this really weird hybrid role, right? Like, I mean, we're all very technically inclined people who know very technical stuff, but in reality, we're kind of like we got to spit out content. We're kind of like, you know, we're kind of like talking sock puppets.
Indeed.
Yes.
Indeed. To be sure.
I feel for Kermit the Frog.
Yes, me too.
I
think he's angry because he's got your hand up his butt.
Well, tell me, Lawrence, what do you think about the developer advocacy role and how do you approach its craft?
You know, one of the ways that I like to approach it is really in reaching people through video. I have a show where I'm a host that I call Coffee with a Googler. Wait, what? So Colt is a developer advocate here at Google, and there's lots of ways that one can be an advocate for developers. And Colt, you've got some pretty unique stuff that you've been working on. Can you tell us about it?
You know, I really try to find the stuff that helps developers that's not part of our normal rigor, okay. Right? You know, so we talk about APIs a lot. We talk about the platform a lot. We talk about how, you know, the new stuff is coming out. But there's a lot of things that are just core and fundamental to making and building great applications that kind of fall through the cracks that no one else is really covering.
Okay.
And to be honest, I really like to focus a lot of my advocacy in those rare areas.
Okay. You know? Like, so I know some examples of that. You've been working on the compressor head.
Yes, yeah.
Android performance patterns.
Yeah, and absolutely.
Tell us about compressor head. I mean, I keep hearing there's this TV show out there. And I mean, did you get the idea from them?
Yeah.
Did they get the idea from you?
So,
those folks in Silicon Valley?
So Compressor Head, for those who may not have seen it, is a show about compression that we do on the Google Developers channel.
Right.
And effectively, it's me trying to distill these really crazy complex algorithms that drive everything we do in computers now. Like, you know, every bit you see on a mobile device has been compressed at this point.
Right.
And distill the algorithms down.
Yep.
Because for some reason, like, the art and science of compression really has kind of fallen away from the education that we've done lately.
Now, some people might say that, like, with bandwidth getting increasingly cheaper and storage getting increasingly cheaper, like, compression isn't really that important. I mean, what would you think about that?
I wholeheartedly challenge that. You have to remember that software is, data is a gas, right?
Mm-hmm.
It will grow to fill whatever container we put in it.
Okay.
And we're going through this great industrial boom right now where hardware costs are coming down, but that is not something that's going to continue indefinitely.
Okay.
Right? Like, if you watch the way that computing has worked over the past 50 years, you end up with these booms and busts, right? Like, you get a huge jump in processing power, and then that'll level off for a while until a new technology comes around and you get a huge one again. And we're seeing that with data right now.
Okay.
And you also have to remember that while our data centers are getting larger and while where we host our content gets larger, the medium between the cell tower and your phone is not growing at that same rate.
Okay.
Right? I mean, you have to remember that almost half of America is still on a 2G network. Worldwide, 2G is like the king's knees. Like, that's the best they can get, especially for the next 5 billion humans that are coming online. They're not going to be on 4G LTE networks.
Absolutely.
Right? So, if you're someone that's trying to create a strategy around getting the most users to your content, trying to build sort of an ecosystem that's data-driven or social networks for these next 5 billion users,
right,
you can't rely on data centers and all these other hardware. Like, you have to compress your data. You know, we kind of talk a little bit about this in the show. There's a couple different spots where we talk about, you know, these things. In fact, I think we have the clip.
We have a clip, Jimmy. Can you run the clip?
The move to front algorithm is pretty simple. For each symbol we read, we write its output buffer position and then move it to the front of our buffer. Now, for example, if we input the letter N, that sits at position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we write that to our output stream.
So that's a pretty complex subject, and you're teaching it quite simply. Is that like the theme of the show? Is that how you do it?
That's exactly what it was. I mean, we're using Lego blocks in there, right? Like, the whole concept came from, like, how do we take this really complex idea and break it down to be able to teach it with sticky notes and Play-Doh and Lego blocks, right? Because, I mean, we got kids, and we're constantly teaching things to kids, and so I figured if this method works on, like, three-year-olds, obviously it'll work on programmers, you know, no offense, but you know. So yeah, I mean, that's the whole gimmick. That's the whole point of the show is how complex can we get from an algorithm and how can we teach it with Play-Doh and sticky notes?
All right, so now as well as Compressor Head, you talk a lot about performance and you have your Perf Matters hashtag and your Android Performance Patterns show. And I think you've just finished up another season of that. Tell us about it.
So Android Performance Patterns is, again, one of those sort of gap-filling initiatives, right? Everyone has to care about performance. If you're shipping an application, users leave feedback about bad-performing applications in a negative manner three times more than anything else in your app. Wow. Like, more than if they don't like the way your social media is laid out, or they don't like how long it takes to download something, or just your UI is bad, that's like crickets.
Sure.
However, if you're slow, or if it feels laggy, man, people just hate it. It's just the truth of the industry
now. And negative reviews, I mean, everybody wants to avoid that.
Yeah, exactly, right? I mean, and you can't fix that with, you know, chiming back with people. Like, you just have to fundamentally fix that at your level. And Android Performance Patterns is built around that gap. Right, because you've got the documentation which tells you how to use the API and what it does, but then you really don't have anything past that to tell you the right way to use it for your performance cases across all the devices in our ecosystem.
Cool.
Right, because I mean, what works on a high-end Android device may not work on a low-end one or on a different device type or form factor or something.
So what are the typical performance gotchas that people have that you might help them avoid with the show?
So there's three big pillars of performance that we like to talk about. So you can either have rendering problems. Okay. So for example, like overdrawing too many pixels on the screen at one time, right? So this means you're gonna be wasting GPU and CPU cycle time. We've also got memory problems. Okay. So this is the quintessential programmer issue, right? Using too many memories, kicking off garbage collection events. Right. In fact, I think we actually have a clip.
We have a clip
of that.
Okay.
We have a clip of that.
Can we run the clip, please, Jimmy?
Yeah.
Even though you're in a managed memory environment, improperly using memory can still kick off a load of performance problems. And allocating too many objects in a short time frame is a clear problem that you should be aware of. You have to remember that the memory heap in Android is segmented up into separate spaces based upon what type of allocation is occurring.
Okay, so in that scene we saw memory, and earlier we're talking about graphics, and the third one, is it battery?
Battery, that's right. I gotta tell you, one of the things that we all hate with our mobile devices right now is you can't get through a day without needing to recharge. I mean, you're doing cool stuff and you need to get it done. But the fact is that most developers aren't thinking enough about how to optimize their battery performance. And we talk a great deal about the things that developers need to do to keep users' battery lasting longer. And I think we all benefit from that. Really.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now that's more than just negative reviews and avoiding them. That's actually making someone's life a little better.
It's a little karma, really. Yeah. I mean, like, as a developer, you kind of want to get that good karma. It's doing the right thing.
Speaking of karma, I keep hearing about this, like, perf like a pirate. I mean, there's good pirates and there's bad pirates, and this seems to be one of the good pirates. So what's this whole perf like a pirate thing?
Yeah.
I've always wanted to go, arr, so, like, now I get to.
Yarr, matey, you got to be doing the right voice.
To be sharp.
It's a little between, like, Irish leprechaun and, like, British weirdo. I don't know.
So that sounds a lot like me.
That's comment in the section, yeah. So Perf Like a Pirate was an event that we started year before last. We ended up wanting to do this event on performance for HTML5 users group in San Francisco, SFHTML5. And just weird dice roll that the event actually happened on Talk Like a Pirate Day.
I see.
And no one really thought about it. It was kind of in the back of everyone's mind. I was like, you know what, we got to do something with this. Right. And so I gave my entire talk in pirate.
Cool.
And so for like the next 6 to 8 months, every time I would go to a conference or something, someone would walk by me and be like, "Yar matey, do we be talking about performance?" Which was fantastic, because I'm like, we got to do this again. So we did it again last year, got a huge turnout, another great set of people. And so it's just kind of really cool to take this really mundane topic like performance that makes everyone's eyes roll back in their head and have fun with it.
Yeah.
And really, Lawrence, like, to me, that's the essence of what we do as developer advocates, is take these really crazy, insane things and make them fun to learn about and fun to bring together and change the way we do our development.
Well, it certainly has been fun having you here today, Colt. Thank you so much for coming.
I appreciate it.
And thanks, everybody, for watching this far. As always, we're on the Google Developers channel. I'm Lawrence Moroni. You can see my link underneath. And Colt McCanlis, you can see his link there, too. So please subscribe to the Google Developers channel for more shows, including Compressor Head and including Perf Like a Pirate. Well, not Perf Like a Pirate. Perf Matters, right? And Android Performance Patterns. Yep. And if you have any other questions for Colt or for me or any other Googlers that you'd like to chat with, maybe even Larry Page himself, please put it in the comments below. Thanks, everybody.